Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. Choosing an IT career is a really tough task considering all the options available. You can choose a career by looking at your passion or your skill sets or even by looking at the job's pay scale. So to help you land a high-paying job in the year 2021, we have put together this informative compilation which consists of the top 10 high-paying jobs in 2021. So now before we move on with this session, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our upcoming videos, and also leave a like if you like our content and want more of these. So now, without any further delays, let's begin with this session. Coming at number 10 is the mobile applications developer job role. As a mobile applications developer, you will be asked to create software for mobile devices. So now it can be Android or iOS, doesn't matter, you'll be writing code to run on a mobile device. So now, mobile applications are embedded in our day-to-day life. If you need a cab, you take up an Uber or an Ola. If you need food, you order from Zomato, Swiggy or Uber Eats. So now, this shows that mobile applications are not going anywhere, and thus the mobile applications developer job role. The skills you would need to become a mobile applications developer is mobile UI design, and you will have to know some back-end computing like security and also database management. Also, you should know a popular programming language, so only then you can code the application like Java, C Sharp or Python. The average salary of a mobile applications developer in India is 5.4 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 17 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $96,000 per annum. The companies who are looking for a mobile applications developer right now are Accenture, Microsoft and IBM. The next role is a full stack developer role. As a full stack developer, you will be involved in all stages of application development. So you will be working on client side and server side applications, or you'll be creating both applications. So to summarize it, you'll be working on the visible part of the application, which is the front end, the invisible part, which is the code of the application, the server side programming, which is the back end, and also make connections to the database. So now, you will need a lot of skills to become a full stack developer. So let's look at the front end skills, which are HTML, CSS, JavaScript and JavaScript frameworks like Angular and Node.js. For backend, you will obviously need to know popular backend languages like PHP, Ruby or Python. And finally, you will also have to know databases like MySQL or PostgreSQL. And if you need NoSQL, then you will have to take up MongoDB as well. And also for version control, you should know GitHub. The average salary of a full stack developer in India is 6 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 16 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $106,000. The companies who are looking for a full stack developer right now are Apple, HP, and Siemens. Coming at number 8 is a DevOps engineer role. As a DevOps engineer, you should understand the software development lifecycle and basically create CI/CD pipelines to make the SDLC more automated. To put it simply, the developers need to only concentrate on the code and developing it, and the CI/CD pipeline handles building it, testing it, and also releasing it. Now, as a DevOps engineer, you should have a lot of skills ranging from automation tools, security skills, and also decision-making skills. Now, looking into the automation tools, you should know a lot of tools ranging from a version control tool like GitHub, then Jenkins, then you'll have to know Kubernetes, Docker, Ansible, Chef, Puppet, Nagios, and there are still a lot of tools, and you'll also have to learn the tools which your company is using. Now, looking at the average salary of a DevOps engineer, it is 6.85 lakhs per annum in India, and it can go up to 25 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $100,000. The companies who are looking for a DevOps engineer right now are General Electric, Paytm and Dell. The next job role, or the seventh role, is a big data developer. As a big data developer, you will be developing solutions for big data problems using Hadoop or other big data tools. Now, you will be choosing the right tool for the problem, then you will be developing the architecture, you'll be developing the actual solution and testing it, and also deploy it. So you'll handle all the phases which I mentioned right now. And as a big data developer, you should have skills ranging from the big data tools to programming languages. So in big data tools, you should know Hadoop or Google BigQuery. In relational databases, you should know MySQL, PostgreSQL or other databases. In NoSQL databases, you should know HBase or MongoDB. And coming to programming languages, you should either know Java, Python or C# or any language which helps you to create these solutions. The average salary of a big data developer in India is 7.1 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 18 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $100,000. The companies who are looking for a big data developer right now are Infosys, Wipro, and Reliance Jio. Coming at number 6 is a data engineer role. As a data engineer, you'll be converting raw and unstructured data into formats of data which data scientists and data analysts can use for analysis. As a data engineer, your process or your work would include collecting, processing, and also storing data which can be used for further analysis. To do these, you should be skilled in SQL and other big data solutions such as Cassandra and Google Bigtable. And also you should be skilled in querying languages, because querying is really important for a big data engineer. So querying languages like Pig, Hive and also SQL, as I already mentioned before, are really important. The average salary of a data engineer in India is 8.3 lakhs per annum, and in the USA it is $103,000. The companies who are looking for a data engineer right now are Google, PayPal and Facebook. Coming at number 5 is an AI engineer. As an AI engineer, you will be developing artificial intelligence models using machine learning and deep learning neural networks to draw business recommendations and insights. So these recommendations and insights can be used to make business decisions which can directly affect the company's growth. Now, as an AI engineer, you should be skilled in programming languages such as R, Python, and Java. Should also be a master in machine learning algorithms. You should have a thorough understanding of statistics, because without statistics, you cannot build models. And also, the most important thing is you should be a great problem solver. The average salary of an AI engineer in India is 7.5 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 20 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $114,000. The companies who are looking for an AI engineer are Apple, Shell, and Amazon. Coming at number 4 is an information system security manager. And as an ISSM, your task is to handle all aspects of security in your company's network. So now, as an ISSM, you should be always handing out security tests every single day, so that you can figure out the loopholes in your company's network and figure out how to solve that. Also, you should be updating the outdated systems, which can be again a loophole for hacking attacks. The skills you will require as an ISSM are strong networking skills, firewall tools, and other security tools. Also, you should be certified in CompTIA Plus security or a CISSP certification. The average salary for an ISSM in India is 15 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 35 lakhs per annum. And in USA, it is $93,000. The companies who are looking for an information system security manager right now are IBM, Flipkart and MoneyGram. Number 3 is a project manager role. As a project manager, you are responsible to get involved in all stages of product development. As a project manager, you should also guide a cross-functional team who are creating, developing and also releasing and implementing the project. So now, as a project manager, your top skills should involve communication, analytical skills and research skills. While guiding a cross-functional team, you should understand and know all the elements of the software development lifecycle and also know the tools around it. As you are guiding a cross-functional team, you should also know some other skills like marketing and market research. The average salary of a product manager in India is 15 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 30 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $103,000. The companies who are looking for a product manager right now are Zynga, Salesforce, and Citrix. Coming at number 2 is one of the most popular job roles right now, which is a cloud architect. As a cloud architect, you should be able to design, develop, and implement cloud solutions for your company. So you will be managing the cloud infrastructure your company already has and also develop new infrastructures. So you will be maintaining it, managing it, and also monitoring all aspects of it. Also, if there is a need, you will be basically collaborating with the DevOps and the development teams. The skills you require as a cloud architect, first, you need the top three cloud providers. You can either learn one of them or all of them. So they are AWS, Azure, and GCP. Also, learning DevOps tools are really important for a cloud architect, like Kubernetes, Docker, Git, and also Jenkins. Also, if you're collaborating with a development team, you would also have to know or also have to have a little bit of knowledge of programming languages. The average salary of a cloud architect in India is 18 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 30 lakhs per annum. And in the USA, it is $107,000. The companies who are looking for a cloud architect right now are SAP, Oracle, and Wipro. Coming at number one for a second year in a row is the data science job role. As a data scientist, you will be solving real business problems with the aid of machine learning, statistics, and your analytical skills. To put it simply, companies are generating enormous amounts of data from social media, IoT, and various applications, and that data is useless until it is seen by the eyes of a data scientist. Now, the skills you should possess as a data scientist, first of all, you should be really strong in statistics, because without statistics, there is no data science. You should be strong in the fundamental machine learning algorithms, also the state-of-the-art machine learning algorithms. Once that is done, you should be really good in programming languages such as Python or R. So, leaving them, a soft skill you need is communication skills. You should be as good as explaining something, as good as you are showing something. The average salary of a data scientist in India is 10 lakhs per annum, which can go up to 40 lakhs per annum, and in the USA, it is $113,000. The companies who are looking for a data scientist right now are Intel, Ericsson, and Amazon. So these are the top 10 highest paying jobs which you should look out for in the year 2021. But anyway, the list will not be the same for everyone. And if you think there should be a different job role in the top 10, please let us know in the comment section down below. And also guys, Intellipaat provides training on most of the trending technologies and highest paying jobs we have discussed, which could help you to land a job in the year 2021. And that brings us to the end of this particular session. I hope this session was helpful and informative for you. If you liked the video, leave a like and also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos. So that's it. Thank you and meet you in another session.